When is it too early to put up Christmas decorations? I don't think it's too early. I think never take them down. Seriously. Seriously. Why would you take them down? Every year you Christians have done this, take more and more of the calendar for your devices. It used to be that Christmas started after Thanksgiving. It started after Thanksgiving. Thanksgiving was its own holiday, okay? It wasn't Christmas halftime. It begins sometime now in late August. If you go to Cracker Barrel, fuck, they're really to the point where it's almost year-round. So seriously, don't take them down. You love the holiday. It's the only time you pricks are ever happy. So fucking leave them up. Who gives a shit? I go to a bar in Appleton, Wisconsin called Cleo's. And and that's the sound of an alcoholic. The only people who really know about Cleo's are people who love to drink. It's just the greatest bar on earth. And one of the reasons is that every holiday they just put decorations up. And it's mostly Christmas decorations, but every holiday they just jam, and they don't take them down. They don't take anything down. They just keep jamming shit up. And so fuck, it's just a great bar. And you go in there and you look and you're happy. And you feel like drinking, because fuck, it's a holiday. This is our last show before the fabulous Christmas season really begins with a vengeance. Oh yeah, oh yeah, you fucking Christians are in for it now. Oh yeah, and especially those of you with kids. God damn it, you're just dumb as posts, aren't you? Just gonna sit there and they're gonna advertise shit and you are stuck with this and fucking I want this, God damn it, oh, fuck, give it to me. Good luck, good fucking luck. Have fun at the, yeah, go to the store. Hey, go to a store, that's gonna be a treat. It's endless. They're not gonna stop playing Christmas music until your ears fucking bleed. And we Jews will go, ha, 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 ha. Son of a bitch. Why? Why you fuckers buy the shit now is beyond my comprehension. When do they sell it cheaper? The day after. Get your shit together. Christmas decorations should fucking go up at Thanksgiving. This is from Atticus Bliss. Christmas decorations should fucking go up at Thanksgiving, or preferably way fucking later. I don't want to think about Christmas until December 1st at the earliest. Christmas lights are a perfect way to take a perfectly reasonable neighborhood and completely trash the ambience. By far, the worst ones are those disgusting rainbow lights that fucking strangle every house in strings of elf cum. I would rather these disgusting motherfuckers paint their houses hot pink than to see this shit every day from October to February. I can't understand what sort of sadist would coat their otherwise reasonable-looking house with these fucking horrendous strands of shit out of one of Banksy's fucking unbelievable, God damn it, fever dreams. The people who own these must be really trying hard to hide the fact that they are serial killers under all of that slimy, degenerate holiday cheer. This is from Noel. This is one of the things that I endure year-round is the moronic, repetitive question about my name. More so the closer we get to the end of the year. You see, my name is Noel, like the damn bloody Christmas song. The first Noel, almost without fail, I'm asked, did you know your name is a Christmas song? Were you born on or near Christmas or in December? Fun fact, I was born in October. I think you can do the math as to why I was named the atrocious name. The next constant moronic response to my name is no one is fucking listening half the time. And call me Nicole, the masculine pronunciation Noel, or my favorite Naomi, which nowhere is close to my name. I'm clearly in my adulthood. Don't you fucking think I know what my name means or the fucking fact that I've heard those questions more than I care to hear? Fuck you assholes and fuck Christmas. Come up with something you original, you piece of shit. How was Cracker Barrel? I went to, on our way here from St. Louis, on the way, if you've never been to Cracker Barrel or Steak and Shake, stop the fuck off. Cracker Barrel is a wonderful place where
where you will never see a menorah, ever. It's a completely Jew-free zone, and I love it there. I do, and they've got every possible candy you could ever fucking want to eat that you ever ate or would want to eat in the future. They fucking have, they couldn't put more Christmas shit in there. There was a Santa, and this is a steal. I don't give a fuck if this is an advertisement. For $100, you can get a little Santa about this big. You can see it on fucking my Facebook page. This is the kind of shit I'm gonna be getting into. And this little Santa, and he's crawling up a ladder to the tree, carrying lights, a string of lights. It's a fucking, I tried to get Ben, my tour manager, to fucking buy this. I got nowhere to put it. It just would be sitting there. I would lean it and he'd be walking. It would make no sense. You've got a fucking tree and children. Look at that little fucker. He looks great. And they play 100 songs. 30 Christmas songs. If there were 100 Christmas songs, I'd fucking take it all and just puncture my ear. All right, it was great. And then we did another one where I just poked Santa in the ass until he got up to the top.
We're here at the Cracker Barrel. And sadly, we've been waiting, but we came at lunchtime, and that's a big mistake, because Cracker Barrel fills up at lunchtime. Because with the idea of three sides with every order, I mean, who can pass that up? We've been waiting here 2.5 hours. I made a little purchase here, but it's a surprise. It's a Christmas surprise for some good friends of mine, because I'm just like Saint Nick.
They have Christmas stuff here?
It's so much Christmas stuff that it's given me diabetes. You can get diabetes at a Cracker Barrel. Not by eating the food, but standing around in the midst of all this Christmas cheer. For those of you who can't get enough of bacon, Baconades. Makes me sweat just thinking about eating one. It's too many things, too little time. Hey. To you seniors out there, why pay for a tooth to be pulled when you can sink your teeth in the Bonhomme's Turkish taffy? You know, don't crack it, just suck on it, and then chew it really hard. You can lose actually 2 or 3 teeth with one of these. God, I used to love these. Can't put them in my mouth now. I'll take out the remaining. I've got things in there that I can't fool around with now.
We're in St. Louis.
Oh yeah, I forgot to tell you. You wouldn't know it. Because every Cracker Barrel is just like in the same place. Evan.
1958.
I've got to go now. I got to see if my food's ready.
What's with car ads at Christmas? Who gives a Lexus or a Mercedes or an Audi or any car to someone for Christmas? Is there something I'm missing? Because I certainly never woke up on Christmas morning to a new car with a huge red bow in the driveway. Been cheated. Well, this is Paula Festinger. Fuck you, Toys for Tots. If I buy a gift for a needy child, it's an act of self-expression, and I need to fucking wrap that present. I love wrapping Christmas fucking presents. Fuck the cause. I'm not giving any unwrapped presents away this year or any years. Stop harassing my fucking mellow, you U.S. Marines. Wow, that is, Paul, I'll send you shit to wrap for me. Nothing I hate more than, I put it in a bag and fucking take it and shut up. And here's the wrap. Sometimes I put the wrapping paper in that I would have wrapped it in. Because when I try to wrap shit, it's just like, oh, really? We just used $180 in wrapping paper to wrap a box that's like 6 inches long. Fuck you. But good for you, Paula, that you get in that Christmas spirit. But really, to tell the Marines to go fuck themselves, that's interesting. It's a lot of courage, Paula. I hope they're not watching tonight.
I've asked for Christmas wishes and New Year's wishes from people, and I've gotten very few. Nobody seems to want to wish for anything. But
This is a Christmas wish and New Year's request all in one. Living on the Eastern Seaboard, we've been hearing that we are in for another shitty, snow-filled fucking winter. 2 years ago, we had enough fucking snow that it wasn't melted until fucking May. Well, Mother Nature, if that is your plans for this year, you can suck my dick! They're having droughts out west, so load all that fucking white shit and send it out west, and you can even have it for free. Merry fucking Christmas. Xmas. You want Xmas wishes? Here's a wish. How about those people that go out and buy toys for homeless kids? Just stop already. Hey, I know you have nowhere to live and many times nothing to eat, but here, have a stuffed animal that you have nowhere to put. Oh, but to see their faces light up. Fuck you. Did it make you feel all fuzzy? Hey kids, we don't care all year that you have no home, food, or necessary things like clothes or shoes, but it's Xmas time, and we're told it's the season of giving. As long as it's materialistic shit that no one really needs, bought from a store, not used. For fuck's sake, how about renting them a room for the night? Or a week? How about making sure your government officials actually give a shit about them and back programs to help them? Oh no, that would be hurting them, because they need to learn to pull themselves up and out of the situation. Those damn takers and lazy assholes. If I have to hear one more fucking right-wing, religious, self-righteous, greedy, selfish fucktard say how much people with nothing are taking from them, I may just bounce their head off the wall. Xmas wishes. I wish there was no Xmas as it's celebrated here by worshiping the almighty dollar and dressing it up as colorful boxes with bows on them. Tis the season, tis the motherfucking season of capitalist bullshit. Merry Christmas. I'm Tomaszewski. I was in a Starbucks in early November and it was full of fucking Christmas shit. I think the crazy Christians have gone so far now that Christmas is waging a war on Thanksgiving. And it was fucking Veterans Day. What about the troops? It's true. Well, I hope they have a merry fucking Thanksgiving. Ron, if you really want to get a sense, the other day we were in, even before that, a couple of weeks ago, we were in a Cracker Barrel where it's like elves, like, inseminate. I'm serious. They come in and inseminate the store. Seriously. The whole place smells like elf cum. It's staggering. It's staggering. They monitor Jews there now. Just during the Christmas season. Just during the Christmas season. It's over the top, though. Fucking, it is unfuck-believable. This is from Alan. It is with regret and a heavy heart that I must direct this rant at you, Mr. Black. Last year, my wife and I had the privilege of attending your performance in Providence, Rhode Island, at which time you spoke fervently of your intention to establish a firearms emporium under the oddly named brand of Jewy Jew's Gun Store. Somewhere in Alabama, in bumfuck Alabama. I'm still working on it, Alan. At the time, I thought little of your comments, but they have since become concerning. You see, I recently went to a yard sale where I purchased about 30 rolls of Christmas wrapping paper for the surprisingly low price of $2 for the whole lot. Supporting my wife's desire to use different wrapping paper for each holiday gift in order to perpetuate the myth of Santa Claus and otherwise deceive our grandchildren when they celebrate the birth of Christ. Where I, a Jew, pronounced with the drawn-out phrasing only that only Mr. Black can affect, do not fundamentally embrace the religious principles of Christmas, I thought that my wife would see my purchase as remarkably open-minded and therefore would be most appreciative and excited by both my haul and the remarkable savings I had achieved. To the contrary, however, she proclaimed me and my actions to be the quintessence of Jewy Jew. God, Love to have dinner with the two of you. Randall Crawford, dear Lewis, as Thanksgiving fast approaches, my stepmom thought it would be a great idea to start putting up the Christmas decorations. Oh, it's coming, fuckers. The first thing she wants up is our 12-foot, yes, you heard me, 12-foot tall Christmas tree. I'll tell you what, that fucker is a nuisance to put up. Usually we have 3 to 4 people to help us with it, but the usual helpers are all doing their own thing for the holidays. So that means me, an 18-year-old boy, and my stepmom, a frail 69-year-old, have to put up this fucking behemoth of a tree. The tree is so damn large that you have to anchor the fucker down with heavy-duty fishing string so the tree doesn't tilt or fall over. Anyway, our tree is ridiculously huge, and I'm not looking forward to putting it together. Happy holidays. So I leave you with this. This is written by our friend Mildred Ellison. She's written in a lot of stuff, and she kind of, it's her Christmas rant. Well, here it is, that time of year again, fucking Christmas. Endless fucking loops of Jose Feliciano and Feliz Navidad. Burl fucking Ives, holly jolly Christmasing. Gene Autry, cowboy warbling, Santa Claus is coming to town, and he ain't talking about all that coked up eight ball snorting sweater wearing Santa either. All those fucking car commercials with people opening the front door on Christmas morning and surprise, here's a brand new Cadillac, Mercedes, Buick, GMC truck, or a fucking Lexus, all with giant red bows on top, and that fucking Lexus doesn't even have a rusty brake drums either. Yet another fucking year when everyone gets one of those brand new red bow Christmassy cars, except me! Fuck! Not only don't I ever, ever, ever get one of those well-appointed luxury vehicles, I didn't even get one of those Peloton things. So I can pedal my Christmas anger and sexual frustration all the way to fucking China. Holy hell, god damn it, skunked again by that cookie-stealing, milk-guzzling, jolly fat fuck Santa. I may as well send my Christmas wishlet to that fucking sewer-dwelling clown in It. At least I might get a red fucking balloon out of it. Merry fucking Christmas and happy fucking New Year's. Same to you all. Take care of each other.